हेलो गाइस। सो आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग योर बायोटिक फैक्टर व्हिच इंक्लूड्स कंपटीशन, नेचुरल एनिमीज एंड फूड, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट योर एबायोटिक फैक्टर। सो एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो, एबायोटिक मीन्स विदाउट लाइफ, यस और नो? दैट मीन्स एबायोटिक फैक्टर्स आर द फैक्टर्स विच आर नॉन लिविंग क्रिएचर्स विच इन्फ्लुएंस द टारगेट ऑर्गेनिज्म। दे वुड इन्फ्लुएंस द सर्वाइवल, ग्रोथ, डेवलपमेंट, ऑल अदर पैरामीटर ऑफ द इंसेक्ट, और यू कैन टेक सम एनी अदर organisms. Got my point? So one by one we will study now. So first we will discuss your temperature. I hope all of you know what is temperature. No need of telling that one. Temperature, we are surrounded with the environment where temperature is essentially required. Yes or no? This is the most important physical factor. Physical means physical things, yes or no? That is the abiotic non-living things, physical thing, yes or no? Which determines the duration of various stages. What do you mean by that? Duration of various stages. Stages means your egg, larva, pupa, adult. So these are the stages. The duration, this is how many days, this is how many days, yes or no? So these are the duration of your stages in the insect life cycle. You see, suppose temperature is influencing the duration, okay, then automatically what will be affected? The number of generations, yes or no? Suppose one moth is there and one aphid is there, okay. Suppose in case of moths, the life stage is your 30 days. Suppose they require 30 days to complete their life cycle. And in case of aphids, they require 5 days. So, in a specific period, okay, during any specific period, like suppose you take 6 months, okay, in this 6 months, which one will cover more generation? Definitely aphids, yes or no? Because within 5 days they are completing their life cycle. That means within 6 months definitely here your more generation, but here less generation because it is 30 days. That means only 6 generation will be completed. But in case of aphids, you see 6 into 6, 36 generations will be completed. Understood how temperature is affecting? Now temperature affects in two way. First is your directly, second is your indirectly. How directly? Temperature will directly affect the survival, development, growth, okay, and abundance of the insect or pest. That is your directly. For the time being, you just know that pest is nothing but an insect. But actually pest includes all those organisms which causes harm, okay, to the human being or human welfare. Leave those things. For now you just understand pest is nothing but an insect, harmful insect, okay. Then coming to indirectly. How indirectly? You see, temperature is an abiotic factor. Some other abiotic factor are your moisture, rainfall, okay, and wind, okay, and some other biotic factor also, like your food, or you can take natural enemies, whatever it may be. So directly means directly temperature will affect the pest, and indirectly means temperature will affect these factors, and these factors again will affect the insect. This is your indirect method. Either temperature will act directly or indirectly through other factors which will be influenced by the temperature, which ultimately will affect or influence the insect survival, growth and development. This is your indirect effect. Got my point? So these are the effect of temperature. Again, we will deal with these things properly. Okay, so now we will understand how animals are categorized based on how they are maintaining the body temperature. Okay, so basically those are divided into two types, but one more type is there in case of insect. So all total three types are there. First is your warm-blooded animals, which is also known as homeothermic animals. Another synonym is there, that is your endothermic animals. So if you will understand these two synonyms, then your this understanding will be completed. So what is homeo? Homo means what? Same or constant? Yes or no? Homeothermic, that means homothermic. That means these are the animals which maintain a constant body temperature within a certain narrow limits. That means here the example is, you see, mammals. Suppose one bear you take. Okay. Whatever may be the surrounding temperature, this mammal or this animal will maintain a constant body temperature. The temperature outside may fluctuate, but the body temperature will not fluctuate. That will be constant under a certain narrow limit, like 1 to 2 degrees centigrade. Maybe fluctuation may be there, but not higher fluctuation according to the environment. So how to define this one? These are the animals which maintain a constant body temperature within certain narrow limits, irrespective of the temperature variation in the external environment. Whatever may be the temperature outside, it may be increasing, it may be decreasing, whatever it may be, they will maintain a constant body temperature. That's why the term is homeothermic. Got my point? Now, why those are called as endothermic animals? Why? Endo means what? Inside. Yes or no? That means these are the animals which depends on internal source of heat to compensate the lost heat to cooler surrounding. That means, you see, suppose one animal is there where that is temperature is high. Okay, that means what will happen? Automatically the body temperature will rise. But what this animal will do, they will depend on its internal physiological process, like they will undergo sweating. Okay, sweating will occur. So automatically what will happen? Their body will become cooler. Yes or no? Suppose the animal is in less temperature condition, a cooler area, then what will happen? They will either undergo exercise or they will consume more food. So what will happen? Inside the body, what? The heat will be generated, the energy will be produced, and automatically this reaction will give warm up to the body. Getting my point? Either it may be summer season or it may be winter season. They will have their own internal physical mechanism through which they can maintain a constant body temperature. That's why they are called as endothermic animals. Example is your mammals. Okay, mammals you take bear, lion, tiger, monkey, everything. Then you take birds, those are also coming under your warm blooded animals. Okay, now coming to the second one, that is your cold-blooded animals. Here also two synonyms are there. One is poikilothermic, another one is ectothermic. If we understand these two, then your whole cold-blooded animals will be completed. What is poikilo? Poikilo means what? Variable. Okay. Poikilo means what? Your variable. Okay. So, try to understand. What happened in warm-blooded? Homo means constant. Here poikilo means variable. That means what will happen? How to define? Animals which are not capable of maintaining a constant body temperature. That means they will have variable temperature according to the surrounding temperature. If outside temperature will rise, their body temperature will rise. If outside temperature is decreasing, then their body temperature will decrease. It will fluctuate along with the environmental temperature fluctuation. That's why they are called as poikilothermic, variable temperature of the body. Getting my point? Next, that is your ectothermic animals. What is that? Ectothermic means they depend upon the external environment. Yes or no? Ecto means outside. Yes or no? That means here what will happen? Suppose you see, here the example is your insect. Suppose a region is there where temperature is very less and the insect is unable to survive. Then what this insect will do? Insect will try to migrate to a place where temperature is higher. Yes or no? That means this insect is depending on the external environment through which they migrate to maintain the body temperature. That's why they are called as your ectothermic animals. They depend upon the environment rather than the metabolic heat to raise their body temperature. Example is insect. Understood? Cold-blooded animals. Now, the last one. Okay? Here we will understand the last one, that is your socio-homeothermic animals. Here what will happen? Insect are poikilothermic. In insect, one insect is there, one species is there, that is your honeybees. Okay? Honeybees are known as your socio-homeothermic animals. Try to understand the terms, then you can easily understand. First is socio, then is homeothermic. That means these honeybees are no doubt poikilothermic as they are insect. But they will convert into homeothermic by using their social development or their society to maintain a temperature slightly above the environmental temperature. That is known as your socio-homeothermic animals. Try to read once. They maintain body temperature slightly above the atmospheric temperature and can air condition their nest. And they will maintain their own temperature inside their colony irrespective of the temperature outside. That means, suppose this is a comb is there. Okay? No doubt, if the honeybees are here and there, they are poikilothermic. But when those honeybees will try to unite together at one place, totally congregating, totally overcrowding will be there. Okay? So here what will happen? Automatically in this specific region, the temperature will rise. Yes or no? You see, suppose you have two situations. This is a 25 square foot flat, you can tell. Suppose in this, what is happening? Only 3 members are there. And in this, some 10, 25 members are there. More members are there. Where the temperature will be more? Definitely here. Same thing will happen here. In this specific site, when the whole colony will try to exist, then what will happen automatically? The temperature will be more than the एक्सटर्नल एनवायरमेंटल टेम्परेचर. यस और नो? दैट मीन्स डेफिनेटली दे आर मेंटेनिंग ए ओन कॉलोनी टेम्परेचर इरेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द टेम्परेचर आउटसाइड. दैट्स वाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज सोशियो होमियोथर्मिक एनिमल्स. पोइकिलोथर्मिक एनिमल्स विच आर बिकमिंग होमियोथर्मिक बाय यूटिलाइजिंग देयर सोशियल डेवलपमेंट सोशियल इंस्टिंक्ट ऑफ देयर कॉलोनी नॉट इंडिविजुअल. देयर कॉलोनी टेम्परेचर विल इंक्रीज अबव द एक्सटर्नल एनवायरमेंटल टेम्परेचर. दैट इज योर सोशियो होमियोथर्मिक एनिमल्स. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस थिंग्स. इफ यू हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड टिल नाउ, हियर यू सी आई हैव गिवन यू द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन और यू कैन ऑल्सो सी इन द सजेस्टेड वीडियो. देर यू कैन ऑल्सो हैव ए सेपरेट वीडियो, कार्टून वीडियो यू कैन वॉच फॉर योर मोर डीपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग.